Hola y bienvenidos a la versión española de mi canal. Preparaos para embarcaros en un emocionante viaje.
Hola a todos. Hoy vamos a hablar de AWS. Pero antes, ¿qué es AWS? AWS son las siglas de Amazon Web Services. Una plataforma de servicios en la nube que ofrece funciones de computación, almacenamiento, entrega de contenido y otras funciones. AWS es como una caja de herramientas virtual. Tiene todo lo que necesitas para construir una infraestructura de tecnología de la información en la nube. Por ejemplo, si eres una empresa que necesita ampliar su capacidad de computación o almacenamiento, AWS puede ofrecerte esa capacidad a demanda. En resumen, AWS es un conjunto de servicios en la nube que permite a las empresas y desarrolladores escalar, innovar y mantener el costo bajo control. Espero que te haya gustado. Hasta la próxima.
Today's video is all about the AWS Free Tier account. Perfect for students that want to practice the hands-on exercises. So what exactly is the AWS Free Tier account? It's basically the free package offered by Amazon Web Services, allowing beginners to explore select services for no extra charge. AWS Free Tier account is an awesome platform for those who are taking their first steps into the world of cloud computing. It's an amazing opportunity to learn, experiment, and even develop small-scale applications without any cost to you. You might be wondering if there are any catches. Well, the free tier account lasts for 12 months from the day you start your account. After that, it's no longer free and you only need to pay for what you use. So, it's your choice whether to sign up for the free tier account, but if you do, this will allow you to create application getting your hands dirty using one of the biggest cloud infrastructures. Do you have to have an account to prepare for the exam? Absolutely not. But for some of us, hands-on helps us to understand better. So, it is highly recommended to use the free tier account. To set up your AWS free tier account, this is the information you need to have handy. 1. Email address. 2. Give your account a username. 3. Home address. And 4. Credit card. Yes, you have to give a credit card because if you access resources outside the free tier account, you're going to be charged. For practice purposes, there's only one reason to venture outside your free tier account. So, let me walk you through creating an account. After pulling up your browser, type in aws.amazon.com. Once you type in this information, you will get the sign up page. At the sign up page, click on sign up at the top right corner. This will take you to area where you can start putting in the information you mentioned. This where you put in your email, username, password, credit card, etc. From here, you can just follow the prompts to walk you through creating the account. As I said earlier, you do not have to create an account. This is only if you want to play around with creating applications. Let's pull up the AWS console and examine the format and layout. This is a sample of what the console looks like. You won't have to do anything in the console on the exam. If you become a solution architect, you could be in charge of customer accounts, which means you could be working from the console, providing resources for your client. The console should not be your primary focus at this point. The AWS console is a user interface that lets you manage the Amazon Web Services in the cloud. For the most part, all cloud resources are managed in the console. Imagine having the power to control the vast resources of the cloud right at your fingertips. That's what the AWS console offers you. The console might seem complex initially, but it's just about getting familiar with the setup and layout. You can create, manage and monitor all your AWS services from here. This is just a short intro to the console. We will divide it in a later lesson. Based on the algorithm we reuse, the console itself is not a primary focus for the exam. However, there are certain services in the console that will really help to bring Amazon Web Services to life. Services like the VPC, Internet Gateway, NAT Gateway, Subnets, Instances, Andrew Tables. We will be covering these services in detail which will help broaden your understanding. So, stay tuned.